This episode is brought to you by Squarespace.com. Hey everyone, Howard Pinsky here with another Photoshop tutorial. Recently, I participated in a Google Plus Hangout with Richard Harrington, Melissa New, and Brian O'Neill Hughes from Adobe. And during that hangout, which I'll link down below in the description, I posed the question to Brian as to whether or not Content Aware is going to make its way into video editing within Photoshop. Unfortunately, the short answer is probably not. It would require an insane amount of computing power, and it would probably find its way into video editing applications like After Effects before it found its way into Photoshop. So I started thinking, is there a way to fake Content Aware in Photoshop when editing videos? The short answer to that is yes and no. Let me show you. So here I am in Photoshop with a video that I've been working on. It's a little promotional video that I did for a company that I'm working with, and there's a problem. I recorded this in my loft, and over here on the ceiling to the right, I've got a sprinkler, which is very distracting. I like pretty much all the rest of it, but that sprinkler needs to go. Unfortunately, it's a video, so if I were to grab my spot healing brush tool and try and paint on it, well, it would get rid of it, but if I press the spacebar to play the video, it's back. That only applied it to that first frame, or the frame that I painted on. So I'm going to undo that, scrub back to the beginning. So what we're going to do, we're going to access the camera raw filter that's new in Photoshop CC. Now before I add any filters to the video, you want to make sure to first convert it into a smart object. That way that filter is then applied to every single frame in your video. And that can be done either by right-clicking on the video in the layers panel and choosing convert to smart object, or you can head up to filter and then convert for smart filters. They are two different terminologies, but they do exactly the same thing. So whether you're converting it for smart filters or to a smart object, it's the exact same thing. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that. Now it's a smart object. As you can see in the layers panel, we have the smart object thumbnail. And this will allow me to add filters to the whole entire video and not just a single frame. So I'm gonna go up to the top, filter, camera raw filter, and here is camera raw, just like you would use on your photos, but now you can also use it on video. So if I want to make any adjustments, like increase the contrast or decrease the highlights, increase the shadows, anything like that, I can very easily do that right within camera raw, and these adjustments will be applied directly to my video, which is awesome. But the point of this video is to get rid of that nasty sprinkler that's at the top right corner. And to do that, within Camera Raw, you have this tool right here, which is your Spot Removal tool, which is basically like Content Aware Fill. And all I'm going to do is take my mouse, I'm going to decrease my brush a little bit with the left square bracket key, and simply paint right over top of the sprinkler. I'm going to leave a little bit of a threshold around the radius, just so it has enough room to feather, and let go. And you're going to notice that sprinkler is gone. And if it didn't do a perfect job, you can always drag the source to a new location, just like that. But it does look pretty nice. I'm gonna press H to hide my overlay. That does look pretty nice. And I'm gonna press OK. And you're gonna notice, not only has it applied all the adjustments I made through Camera Raw, but it also got rid of the sprinkler. Now if I press the space bar on my keyboard, my video is going to play, but very, very, very slowly. Trust me, it's playing. You can see it very slowly moving, but basically Photoshop is going through every single frame and applying all the adjustments that I made, including that spot removal, as you can see there it goes, to each and every frame. So the rendering process is very similar to how you would render your videos in any other video editing application. But once it does render, your video is going to look nice and smooth. And once you're happy with the final result, you can go ahead and export it right at the bottom left. You can click on the export button. You can give it a name, choose where you want to save it, and hit that render button. And once all is said and done, as you're seeing on the screen now, I now have my final video exported to my computer without that distracting sprinkler. And all of this was done within Photoshop. And a lot of you may be asking, well, why can't I use After Effects for this? Well, you can, but if some people don't have After Effects and they only have Photoshop, they may want to edit their videos in Photoshop. And since Photoshop CS6, video editing has improved substantially. And now with the camera off filter in Photoshop CC, you can make amazing adjustments to your videos, export them, and have an amazing result. And that is that. Content Aware Fill, sort of, on your videos in Photoshop. It's not the perfect solution, but it's a little bit better than what we have now, which is no Content Aware Fill on our videos in Photoshop. Hopefully this technology comes around at some point in the future. I'm not holding my breath because, like I mentioned at the beginning, it requires a ton of computations. Is that a word? I don't know. It is now. And it probably will end up in After Effects or any of those other applications before it ever ends up in Photoshop. So, that being said, if you do find yourself working on a video in Photoshop and the camera isn't moving and you have a few spots you want to get rid of, this technique may help you out just a little bit. Thanks for watching, guys. Let me know in the comments below what you'd like to see in a future video. More Photoshop tutorials are coming soon, and those are thanks to my sponsor, Squarespace.com. I talk about these guys a lot, and it's not just because they're paying me, which is always nice, but because they're a fantastic web hosting and web design service. Check them out, Squarespace.com, link right over there, coupon code right over there, which saves you 10% on your first purchase. They're open 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, so if you're working on your website at 2 in the morning, like we all do, and something doesn't work because you're messing with the code, like we all do, you give them a call. They're based in New York City. They fix your problem. Most likely. They've got templates up the wazoo for whatever type of website you're looking to design. They're all responsive, so they fit your mobile device. They've won a ton of awards. What more can you possibly ask for? Check out squarespace.com. Use that coupon code right there. Save 10% on your first purchase, and I will see you guys in the next video. Take care.